GameFront, and we're gathered with Evan Jones, and we're about to take a look at Terrarium. Yeah, I have a hard time pronouncing it.
You got to really lean into terror. You got to say Terrarium.
Terrarium.
Yeah, there
it is. I feel like I've been drinking when I say it.
Yeah, I think that's fine. I mean, we set up a website, which is murder.garden, and that is enough for people to remember. So, you know, we can call it Murder Garden if you need to, but Terrarium is the title.
I like Terrarium a lot. It's fun to say. I just feel like it's even more fun to say once you've been, never mind.
It's kind of a game for that kind of activity.
It seems like it.
It's a game of total destruction. It's a game of adorable gore. That's something that we really have coined for this game. And really, it's about player-made murder gardens, which is how we came up with our website. And the game is all about building your own bizarre alien worlds that are set up to destroy the cutest creatures in the galaxy, these tiny Moogoo that you can lob at things. Some of them break objects, some of them light things on fire. There's all these different tools you can use in the game, but the idea is that you have to keep them alive. If you run out of them, then the game is over, but you also have to be careful because if they breed out of control, they can take over the entire planet.
Cool. Well, let's take a look at what's happening here, and
Sure. Maybe
you can tell me what we're looking at.
Yeah, well, we're playing along in the background, and right now you can see he's using the heavy Moogoo to blast open this this rock wall. But this is an action puzzler game, and you can see this giant mushroom actually weighs down like a pressure plate. You can fill it up with the Moogoo, and then he's going to launch the Moogoo outside of the gate so that he can actually get up over. These spikes are going to kill the gardener, our wily space grandmother. We call her the gardener. And what I can see on the other side is a whole lot of carnage over there. You can see that there have been many, many Moogoo.
Those are all dead Moogoo?
Oh, no, and they've all gone into the water. This is rough. So there's many drowned Moogoo here, but we are going to... Oh, no!
And his population is now at one?
We're at one Moogoo left.
And I heard you had to have reproduction, right?
So this is the name of the game, is that you can see these tiny little skulls. These are the Moogoo corpses.
Yeah.
And that is actually the secret to the game, which is that these Moogoo multiply as they touch corpses. So they actually like use their own corpses to spawn new ones.
That's a little creepy. They mate with the corpses.
Yeah, I mean, I said it was adorable, but I didn't say it was, you know, PG all the time. And this is really a game where you learn the different tricks that every one of the Moogoos use. That was a gassy Moogoo that's taking us through this level. And we're going to switch to the heavy ones that we can break down. And so every single one of them, it's kind of like an escort mission from hell here, because we're trying to keep these guys safe, but we're also using them in this disposable way. They're constantly being expended and replenished. And so now we've broken the force field. This is called our prime specimen. And our prime specimen is like the most exotic plant in the galaxy that we want to capture and we want to add to our own terrarium.
And once we have that in our terrarium, does it give us a new Moogoo? What do we gain by capturing one of those?
So we're working on that collectible aspect right now. Right now, because we're in early access, we just have the one prime specimen. We have a ton that we've already modeled, but we had to make choices, and we chose to focus on maker mode.
Okay.
So the big bang for your buck in this game is that every single one of the assets in the game can actually be placed in a blank slate. You can build your own level, and you can test it out and play through it completely on your own. You can cut, scale up and down, rotate things around, and then once you're ready, you can publish it through Steamworks, and you can download other people's murder gardens.
So is it kind of like you're creating dungeons for other people to play?
Very
much
so.
And as you unlock more, you have more pieces to your dungeon to challenge other players?
Well, it makes the game just a much more robust game. Right now we've got a tutorial that takes you to 24 levels, but we've got so many more player-made levels that are up there on Steam as well. So people really want to have, you know, they ask us how many hours of gameplay is this game. It's an unlimited number of hours because you can constantly be trying new people's levels, you can be building your own levels and expanding the game.
Is there going to be a story campaign, or are you going to use the tutorial for the story?
So right now, our early access is maker mode plus tutorial levels, and what we're really working on next is to get the story campaign down. I've told you a little bit about it. I could talk for days about the lore of the gardener.
Can you at least tell me a little bit, because the gardener's not just any hero. It's a woman protagonist,
yep.
Right?
So we like to call her our wily space grandma, and this wily space grandma cares only about one thing, which is winning the Intergalactic Horticultural Society Society Blue Ribbon. And the way that she's going to do that is by collecting these prime specimens all over the galaxy, and she doesn't care what happens as long as she gets that prize. And so there are levels that you just splatter completely wall to wall with these Mugu gore, and there is very little consequence to that because it's a game about playing sort of devilishly wrong. It's about really leaning into the fact that there sometimes doesn't have to be consequences to your actions and that you can get away with things. And so
murder. You can get away with murder.
And so it's a game that of just constantly loving, you know, the delicious part of just watching these games go horribly wrong.
Do you have a certain rating level that you're trying to... do you want it to be accessible to children, or do you want this to be more adult-orientated?
I mean, we built it thinking about, you know, older gamers, but we also have been testing it a ton on kids. I mean, it's all cartoon violence. It's nothing to do... The Mugu splat and pop and you know, leave their traces all over the place, but there's no blood. It's always cartoon gore in different colors. You see this rainbow on the level at the end. We find that kids love it because they get the idea of, like, you know, there's this amazing moment playing this game where people, they start out thinking that it's an escort mission, and they play the game like, oh, I've got to protect these guys at all costs, right? And then suddenly one of them dies, and they realize, oh no, this game is much, much darker, and they start to really embrace the chaos of it.
So you lose both when we have zero population, but you also lose at the maximum population?
And so it's two completely different moments, right? When you run out of Mugu, you have no more tools. You're stranded alone in this dangerous alien planet. But when you hit the maximum population, you have actually let loose the most invasive species in the galaxy at a critical mass that has now ruined this ecosystem. And so you lose the game because you've destroyed the world.
I was just going to ask what the lore is of why too many is bad.
Yeah.
Because at a certain level, they're no longer containable.
Exactly. It's a game. We like to call it like a game of population control, a game of chaos management. And so the idea is that you are trying to keep this sweet spot of just having enough that you always can succeed at the next puzzle.
Cool. So this is in early access now. People can find it on Steam.
It's ready on Steam. The easiest way to find it, if you can't spell Terrarium, then
just say it into Google Voice. Terrarium. It'll work, right?
Our website is murder.garden, and we find that people are much more easily remembering that.
How many times do people accidentally come to murder.garden because they were doing something else?
Well, yeah, I mean, I hope that we don't attract that kind of thing, but we're having a good time, and I mean, we've had so much fun making the game and really like leaning into some of the just like ridiculousness of it. Yeah, it's all this like low poly art style that really brings out alien plant life, and then the plant life attacks you, so it's completely surprising in that way.
Cool. Well, thanks for your time, Evan.
Hey, thanks so much.
And I look forward to getting my hands on it to play.
All right. Thanks again.